Hey guys, it's Skinface here, and welcome back to episode 19 of my Manchester City career mode. Now, in today's episode, we're going to be getting through a few more matches. The first game is against Hull City. We will be simming that match because it's a game against Hull City. It's a home match in the Premier League. We'll just sim it, and we'll get on to the game against Sevilla in the Champions Cup quarterfinals. So quite a big match that one for us. Hopefully get ourselves underway nicely in the quarterfinals of the first leg of the Champions League game that we have here. Then a game against Southampton 3 days later. That's an away match in the Premier League. We will play that one, and we might well have enough time to get to the next leg of the Sevilla match. We'll just have to wait and see how we get on for time in today's episode. But before we get into things, if we could try and 100 likes, I would really appreciate it. Also, if you're new to the channel and you haven't subscribed already, then please go ahead and hit that subscribe button as well. It'd be absolutely fantastic. I really do appreciate all the new subscribers coming on board. And yeah, like I say, we are going to be simming this first match. Also, again, apologies that there's no face cam. That'll be back next episode, because by the time the next episode comes out, I will have finished all my exams. So I'll be back face cam for next episode. This is something I'm going to go with for the game against Hull City. We will submit through the usual route and hopefully get ourselves 3 points. A little bit risky given the fact that, of course, we are fighting for the title here. So any drop points against these sort of lesser sides is pretty bad. So hopefully it's going to happen here. It's a home match, so that should mean we've got a slight advantage. It's a changed team, though, and we're waiting. Oh, no, that's not a good start. We've equalised, though, through Gundogan. 20 minutes in, it's 1-1 here. And that was not the start I expected. 16 minutes in, approaching half-time, still remains 1-1. Into the second half, yeah, Torres come on, Fernandinho comes off, and Lozano puts us in front. That's 2-1, that's good news for us. 25 minutes to go, can we extend that lead maybe? 15 minutes left now, need to get a third goal. We have done through Gabriel Jesus, and with a couple of minutes to go, we win the game 3-1, and three different goal scorers gets us the 3 points. Okay, so good news, good way to start the episode by getting the 3 points. A little bit risky, I was worried for a second when we went 1-0 down, but we managed to claw it back and get a comfortable victory in the end. Let's crack on with some player drills here before we get onto the game against Sevilla. Look forward to that match against Sevilla. It should be quite an interesting game for us to see how we get on against them. As you can see this week, plenty of attributes going up. Nobody going up an overall though, but Hill's getting very close to 55 overall now. Oh, we got some really good injury news just before this game against Sevilla. Fabian Delph is returning from injury, so that's great news for us. Obviously, we were hoping for Raheem Sterling, but Fabian Delph will give us another option in midfield. He will be back for this next game though. He'll have to wait until the next episode, I'd imagine, to be honest, when he comes back. Saul saying thanks for playing him. He was complaining not so long back that he wasn't playing enough. We've kind of just continued to play in the same amount, but he seems happy enough, so that's good. Now it's the game against Sevilla. Let's change around the team. And this is how I'm going to go with for the game against Sevilla. A very tough match, this one, potentially. So we are going with a very strong team. Edison starting in goal. Kyle Walker, Kompany, Otamendi, and Bertrand in defence. In midfield, we have Saul, Kevin De Bruyne, and Silva. And the front three, as ever. Or in fact, slightly changed this time around. Leroy Sané on the left-hand side. Aguero up front with Gabriel Jesus on the right-hand side this time around. We did have the option of Lozano, but I'm going to go with Gabriel Jesus. And we'll see how he gets on in that position. I don't think we've played in there before, so hopefully he plays well there. And that's left us with the bench looking like this. Plenty of different options for us, just in case we need them. Fabian Delph, not actually that far away from returning from injury, so might well be back if we do play the second leg of this Sevilla match. Okay, so here we go for this match against Sevilla. It is the away leg, so of course any goals here would be absolutely fantastic for us, just to give us the advantage going into the second leg. So it'd be really good if we could get a few goals here, just to put us at ease and hopefully get us through into the semi-finals, maybe even after this game. So we'll wait and see what happens. Got to perform well here. I'm expecting a difficult performance though from Sevilla. I expect them to play well against us. I think that they might have a few good opportunities. Just got to try and limit them wherever we can. Chance. Oh, good block there from Ryan Bertrand, I think, and prevented that opportunity. Now a chance for us to counter-attack. Our first venture forward. Gabriel Jesus is running, going to try and pick out Sergio Aguero. What a pass, Aguero, and he makes it 1-0 with our first shot of the game. It's Aguero with the goal, 6 minutes in. Gabriel Jesus there, playing the ball through, and it was a really, I think it was a poor goalkeeping decision. It was difficult to tell exactly. I felt like when he came out, he made it a little bit easier for us, but we'll have to watch it back on the replay, because to me it seemed like a strange goalkeeper decision. Didn't know whether he was coming for the ball or not. He does come out here, I don't know how early he does it though. He comes out relatively early, but then stops. I think maybe he should keep running at me. But of course, I'm not going to complain, because we've scored. It's 1-0. And that gets us an away goal very early on. Oh, ball through to Bernardo Silva. It's actually going to find him. Oof, an interesting challenge to make. Just about got the ball. Bernardo Silva now going to look to Kyle Walker. He's going to play inside to Sergio Aguero. Oh, maybe overplayed it a bit there. It's frustrating. Kevin De Bruyne, oh, what a pass that is. Gabriel Jesus now going to look to try and get a bit direct into the box. Still trying to run his way through. Maybe could have passed it, but went a little bit more direct that time. Didn't quite work. Chance for Sevilla. Oh, again, a good opportunity for them. This time, a little bit closer than the one before, but certainly getting much closer now to getting themselves an equaliser. Aguero into Gabriel Jesus. He's now going by himself. He's going to have to try and create something here just before half-time. Still going here. Going to cut back inside. Going to look to Sergio Aguero to shoot. Gets blocked. Nearly fell into the path of Gabriel Jesus again. But it's half-time. It's 1-0. A strong end to that first half, but need a second goal, really. Not had loads of clear-cut chances. Sevilla starting to come into the game a little bit more towards the end of the first half, but still not threatened us that much. A couple of shots here and there, but likewise, not much that's being clear-cut, to be totally honest, from them either. Got to try and add to the scoreline, though. We've got to focus on getting ourselves a second away goal, and that would really give us a massive boost going into the second leg. Okay, so there's just over 15 minutes to go here. We're going to make all three changes. Not been that many chances, to be honest, in the second half, so we are going to make some changes now to try and liven things up a bit. Fernandinho, Fernandes, and Lozano all to come on. Silva, Kevin De Bruyne, and Gabriel Jesus all to come off. Freshening up the team a little bit. Fernandes has done a good job for us when coming off the bench recently, so hopefully he can try and get us a second goal. But yeah, it's been a bit of a strange second half. Not many chances whatsoever to show you. Oh, I thought that was going to be one for Sevilla then. But yeah, we are obviously wanting to get ourselves a win here, wanting to keep a clean sheet, but we would like to get a second goal as well. Lozano running forward, going to cut inside onto his left foot and shoot. It's just past the post. Could have probably just passed it to his Leroy Sané or Aguero there. Really good opportunity to get a second. Felt like the shot was the best option, but looking on the replay, definitely not. Two great positions there for our other attackers. Could have easily got a second goal. Saul out to Leroy Sané. Maybe a final chance for us here. Getting close to the end of the match. Still not many opportunities in the second half. And it's a ball through, nearly picking out Aguero. Would have been a nice little pass through. Don't think that second goal is going to quite come for us in this match. It's been a shame because it's not even like we've had that many chances in the second half. The second half has been much worse than the first in terms of chance creation. But the game has finished 1-0. We've won the match. That's the main thing. We've got ourselves an away goal as well, which will help us going into the second leg. But it would have been nice to have nicked a second goal if we could have. And we just didn't manage to do it. A quick update on the league table. It looks like Chelsea actually must have lost their last game, I think. I'm assuming that anyway, because they're now 10 points behind us. So they've got even further behind us now. I'm not really too sure who they're actually playing. Chelsea, yeah, lost to Bournemouth 2-1. Okay, that's obviously great news for us. We're now 10 points in front of them with just 6 games to go. So that's absolutely incredible news, and of course means that we're getting very, very close now to winning the league title. We need 9 points, I think, to win the league title. So, yeah, I think Chelsea's maximum for the last 6 games will be an extra 18 points. So they can get 80 points now in total. We've got to get 81 to win the league. So we need 3 more wins, really, to be able to win the league. And we have a chance to get one of those wins in this next match against Southampton. So we'll change around the team, and we'll decide what sort of team I'll put out for this game, because of course we do have another match against Sevilla in a few days' time. Okay, so this is how I'm going to go with for the game against Southampton. Edison will start in goal, summoned out right back, Stones, Hernandez, and Mendy in defence. In midfield, we've got Fernandinho, Gundogan, and Yaya Toure, and then the front three, Nolito, Iheanacho, and Lozano all starting. So, a decent enough team, considering this is a heavily changed side. There's a lot of good players still left in this team, so a really strong team in terms of the amount of depth we have in the side. And, yeah, you can see this the bench as well. Fabian Delphegat's on there, still recovering from his injury, but he could get a few minutes here in preparation, maybe for the Sevilla game or another match if we need him further down the line. But still a few bigger names missing out. Sergio Aguero not in the team at all due to lack of fitness. He will be back for the game against Sevilla, though. I still can't believe Chelsea have dropped more points against Bournemouth as well, of all teams. Really was not expecting that. They had such a strong start to the season, and I just felt that they were going to still, you know, manage to remain with us as part of the front two. So I'm not really too sure what's happened to them recently, Charles, but they're starting dropping quite a few points, and they've made it a little bit easier for us to go on to win this league title now. So we're 10 points in front of them, need another 9 to go on to win the league title. And yeah, let's see if we can get 3 of them in this game against Southampton. Iheanacho into Yaya Toure, you can hit one. Oh, I thought it was 1-0 already. What a strike from Yaya Toure. Brilliant little 1-2 there with Iheanacho on the edge of the box. Would have been another early goal for us if that had gone in. What a hit. Hits it so cleanly, but it's just wide. Really dominant display early on. Need to get ourselves a goal, though, to really show that. At the moment, Southampton are really struggling to get out of their own half. Clearing it, but it's going straight back to them. Yes, well played. Iheanacho onto Fernandinho. Need that run from Lozano. He's been a little bit reluctant to make it. Can he pull it back here? Fernandinho with a strike and gets blocked brilliantly by Yoshida. It's out for a corner. That's one of our better chances, I think, in this match so far. Really good little cutback. I'm not so sure that it was going in or whether Fraser Forster had it, but it is out for a corner. It's going to be short to Nolito, but good ball in, hopefully. Nice. It's an easy save. Hernandez looked to switch it. What a pass. Love those sort of passes across the field. Lovely little diag. Can we have a 1-2 here? Iheanacho. Oh, so close. Iheanacho's won it back off Van Dijk. Plays it inside now. Gundogan need to try and do something before half-time here. Being the dominant team, but just don't have the scoreline to show it yet. Nolito into Fernandinho. Now looking to Iheanacho. Nearly had it. Just let it run away from him. It's half-time. It's 0-0. Like I was saying before, it's a dominant performance at the moment, but we just don't have the scoreline to show it at the moment. It still remains 0-0. Frustrating because, yeah, we really have had the better of the opportunities. I wouldn't say that many clear-cut chances. A few of them have just been blocks in the last few seconds, and we just haven't managed to get that shot on target. But overall, we have had the better of the opportunities. Got to have a finish, though. Need someone to step up and smack on the back of that, ideally. Oh, what a ball in. Oh, what a save, Edison. I know it was right at him, but there's some power behind that. Great chance for Southampton in the opening few minutes of the second half. That's their best chance of the game, if not the best chance of the game for both teams. Gundogan onto Yaya Toure. He's running past the left-back here. Yaya Toure to shoot. Oh, it's over the bar. Gotta keep that down, Yaya. Great opportunity. The second half has certainly livened this game up a little bit. Iheanacho onto Nolito. Needs an overlap here. Oh, it's just about managed to hold on to it. It's a cutback. In fact, it was more of a cross from Yaya Toure out for a corner. Well cleared by the Southampton defence. It's just going to be Nolito to put one into the box. Hopefully away from the goalkeeper, but it's not enough on it. There'll be another corner, though. A chance this time to go short. Gundogan, what's your delivery like? Terrible. Okay, all three changes now. 25 minutes to go. We need to try and find ourselves a goal. We don't want to be dropping points here. We want to try and get 3 points. So we're bringing on Kolarov, Delph and Fernandez. Three slightly different changes. Kolarov in particular. We'll take off Gundogan, Yaya Toure and also Nolito as well. Semedo is going to play as our right winger. Lozano will move on to the left-hand side. Stones will move over to right-back. And we'll go with Kolarov at centre-back. Delph will come on, get some minutes. Hopefully play well for us. Add a bit more pace and energy into the midfield. And yeah, we'll see how that goes. Delph on the counter-attack, needing Lozano here, he's found him. Really good chance for us to counter here. Lozano's getting past Van Dijk. Does he have another option? What a tackle that is from Van Dijk. Smashes into him, takes absolutely everything. It's out for a corner. Fernandez going to look to cross it in. It's not a bad delivery. Kolarov's in there, on his right foot maybe. Okay, it was a little bit different. It's going to be another corner. Nope, kept it in. And of course they take it off us. Oh, what a chance. Just gone wide. Good pass out there to Semedo, completely free now. He's got to try and create something for us here late on. Into Fernandez to shoot, and he's finally scored. It's the youngster that gets himself another goal, and he comes off the bench. Gets us what should be the winner with 6 minutes to go. Fernandez there, it was kind of a 1-2 type thing there between him and Semedo, and he gets the cut back on his left foot and finishes it off around Fraser Forster. Lovely bit of play, and well played from Semedo, getting the assist. Of course, we moved him further forward as well, so happy that he's got the assist, and the substitute gets the goal as well. It's 1-0. It's a late one for us in the final few minutes of the match, but we'll happily take it, and it should be the 3 points in the bank, but of course, there's still 5 minutes to go, and Southampton will throw everyone forward. Oh, how has he got past him so easily? Charlie Austin's still going. Oh no, disaster. It's 1-1. Yoshida, I said to throw everyone forward. You can really tell, can't you? Yoshida gets the goal. Oh, that's embarrassing. I think what I should have done when I went 1-0 up, he's gone 5 at the back, moved Stones back into centre-back, taken back Semedo and put him at right wing-back, but yeah, he didn't, and consequently Stones got pretty much outdone out wide there, and they ran through and equalised pretty swiftly. It's 1-1. Of course, we've seen those sort of responses quite a lot from the computer. It happens when you score. They throw lots of players forward and throw a lot of passes together as well. And generally, 9 times out of 10 can get themselves an equaliser, or at least have a good opportunity to do so. Got ourselves a free kick here, though. There's still time, and we've got to remember that. Hopefully, we can have some sort of special set piece here. I do like my special set pieces. Can we get one here, though, for Kolarov? Can we lose our man, maybe? Oh, Jesus, what is that run-up? That was terrible. That's it. So 1-1 draw. It's disappointing to drop 2 points here in a game where we should have scored in the first half, really. We didn't manage to do it. And at the end, we've dropped 2 points here against Southampton. Frustrating, but two late goals have livened up the match towards the end of the game. But Southampton having more shots on target, not good enough for us. Possession-wise, 50-50. And maybe a draw was fair based on those stats. So not too many goals this episode, which has been a bit frustrating. Not managed to kick on and get ourselves a second goal. That's been the issue in today's episode. It was briefly in the last episode, but I think we managed to correct it in one of them where we managed to get two goals. But this episode so far, just sticking to the one goal per game, which of course is not really enough to win you most matches. Some player drills here before we get on to the next game at Sevilla. I think we'll just about have enough time to get onto that second leg. Hill goes up to 55 overall, that's fantastic news. Ferreira close to 67, Diaz close to 69. Fernandez not too far from 69 as well. Okay, so on to the second leg of the game against Sevilla, the quarter-final match, which we're currently winning 1-0 after an away goal in the last leg. And yeah, we are going with this side for the final game of today's episode. Edison starts in goal, Kyle Walker, Kompany, Otamendi, Bertrand in defence, Sol, Kevin De Bruyne and Silva in midfield, and Leroy Sané, Gabriel Jesus and Aguero as the front three. This is the bench we've gone with. Again, decent options for us. A few of the youngsters on there with Diaz, Garcia and Fernandez there. Again, Fabian Delph on the bench with no out-and-out striker there. So yeah, missing Iheanacho for this game. But I reckon the team should be enough to get ourselves into the semi-finals of the Champions Cup. Let's wait and find out. Okay, here we are at the Etihad Stadium. We've got ourselves an away goal in the bag. We've got to make sure that we keep a clean sheet ourselves, and then we will obviously go through into the next round if that's the case. But to make sure that we do go through, we've got to get ourselves some goals. I'm not happy with 0-0s. I'm not happy with 1-0, in fact. I want to get multiple goals. I want to get us playing some better football than what we've seen in the last few episodes. Got to try and improve us a little bit because we have dipped, I think, in performance in the last few episodes. I know during the season we have played some fantastic football at times, but recently not so much. We've been grinding out results, and that's what you have to do to try and win league titles. You've got to get results when you're not playing particularly well. Hopefully we can play a bit better in this game. Aguero looks to switch it out here to Leroy Sané. Plenty of space to run behind the fullback. Now got to have someone else in the middle. Sané going to have to try and beat Lindelof there. Going to pull it back. Good chance for Silva. Oh, and Nzonzi won it back off him somehow as well, because he was behind Bernardo Silva. Somehow managed to win it back off him. Good chance for us, but just a slight hesitation allowed him to take the ball off us. Oh, Leroy Sané's in behind. Got to have a shooting chance here. Sané saved. Gabriel Jesus. Oh, lovely little flick to get it back in front of him, but he couldn't finish it off on a volley. That would have been a fantastic goal, but it doesn't quite happen. Remains 0-0. Yes, well played, Bernardo Silva. Gonna have to shoot himself. Oh, nearly found the bottom corner. Again, saved by the goalkeeper. Gotta try and find a way to get a little bit closer to the goal, but they're just defending so well that these little passes through aren't really working. Aguero gonna switch it out to Gabriel Jesus. That's a fantastic pass. Now needs to beat these two players, and he's not quite gonna match it. And that's an injury for him, and he is injured. Ugh. How long's he going to be out for? Okay, so Gabriel Jesus comes off, and that means Fernandez comes on. Not good to have to make a change early on, or at least in the first half anyway, especially with it being down to an injury. Frustrating, and Gabriel Jesus there going down, holding some body part. We'll wait and find out after the game. Yes, well played, Fernandez. Cutting it back. Sergio Aguero, can he turn his man and shoot? Oh, off the post. So close. Cleared away by the Sevilla defence, and another chance for us to go forward, but got to be scoring that. Really good opportunity. Sadly, didn't quite come to anything. Aguero turning, shooting over the bar. That's terrible. Half-time, 0-0. Can't believe we've not managed to score again in the first half. Frustrating, because we obviously had that great chance through Sergio Aguero when he hit the post. Just doesn't want to go in the back of the net at the moment for us. Really struggling to get the goals like we have been in previous episodes. So, yeah, got to try and change things up. Maybe look at a different formation. Maybe go for a 4-3-3 attacking. But, yeah, a bit frustrating at the moment because we've not got that first goal. Oh, what a pass. And Zonzi's made a good run. Will he keep it in? He has done. Goes for the cross as well. Bizarre thing to do, but it nearly worked out. Okay, so we are going to change the formation. 4-3-3 attack. Silva, I go at centre attack in mid. Just over 30 minutes to go now. Sol into Silva. Good chance here for Kevin De Bruyne to hit one. Always found the back of the net. What a strike that is. We literally made the change a few seconds ago. He probably isn't down to the change whatsoever, to be honest, but we've managed to get ourselves a goal, and that is a brilliant strike from Kevin De Bruyne. Good layoff as well there from Fernandez. Right foot and smashes it past the goalkeeper. It's 1-0, 2-0 on aggregate as well. That gives us a nice lead now. The opposition have to score two goals in order to get through. 30 minutes to go, and we have managed to get the opening goal. Finally, got to try and add to it now. We don't want just a 1-0 win. We want to try and get multiple goals. Oh, what a save from Edison. That's a really good hit. I don't know who's hit that one from Sevilla, but it's a fantastic strike. Good save out for a corner. Sevilla really stepped it up. Since we got that second goal, they are not happy, and they are really going for it now. I wouldn't be surprised if they do score at some point. It's going to be Nasri to put in the ball. Edison should get there, and he does. So all over to Leroy Sané. Good chance, maybe for a switch. Silva stopped running, but he's going to have to get going now to get that ball. Going to play it inside maybe to Fernandes if that opportunity arises, but it doesn't. Out for a corner. Sadly couldn't convert that into a second goal maybe in this game. Doesn't quite happen again for us. Kevin De Bruyne will put the delivery in. Anyone? No, it's under hit. Silva on the edge of the box to hit it though, and that's wide. Final two changes now. Diaz and Delph to come on. We'll take off Kevin De Bruyne and Silva, and we'll see how they get on for the final 13 minutes of the game. So hopefully we can add to the scoreline, but of course we just want to get through, to be honest. Although, like I've been saying, we need to get ourselves more than one goal in the game. That's it. It's a 1-0 win. Again, not good enough really for us. But we do get through into the next round. That's the main thing. It's a 2-0 win on aggregates. Two clean sheets as well. Very good against Sevilla. A tough side with actually some good opportunities in this game in particular. They did play quite well, especially since we got that goal, which obviously put us 2-0 up on aggregates. But overall, I think we do deserve to get into the next round. Very happy that we have got into the semi-finals. But we need to find a way of scoring more goals. At the moment, we are not scoring enough goals to my liking. We're just about getting through every match. We don't really want to have to do that, especially against the bigger teams. You're not really going to have those sort of opportunities. Is just to win by one goal. So we'll wait and see how we get on in the next episode and hopefully try and find a way of scoring a few more goals. You can see that we only had 38% possession, 6 shots, 4 of which on target. So yeah, definitely to improve our ball retention a little bit, not doing so well on that side of things. Might well have Real Madrid in the next round, so that could be fun for us. They beat Tottenham 4-2. Also in the semi-finals are Arsenal and either Bayern Munich or potentially Borussia Dortmund as well. How have Arsenal got this far? Well, that is everything for today's episode. Thank you all so much for watching. Next time round, we do have a game against Spurs in the semi-finals of the FA Cup to play. So tough game, that one, to try and get us into another final. And yeah, we'll wait and see how we get on with that match next time round. Thank you all so much for watching. If we could try and hit 100 likes on today's episode, I'd really appreciate it. Also, if you're new to the channel or just haven't subscribed yet, then please go ahead and hit that subscribe button as well. It'd be absolutely fantastic. And I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.